Go on, then, before it gets too dark.
I'll handle this.
Anyone need supplies? I've got... brought a whole wagon full of goods to sell, but not enough shirts for the road. Say, is there anything you need? I've got some basic traveling supplies for sale, if you'd like to take a look. I'm a trader, originally from the Adir Empire, but I've been trying to establish new business out here. Life on the road has brought some unexpected challenges, to be sure. And I'm sure you've noticed how prickly the locals can be. But we're here to make the most of things, right? Something else you need? It's not as big as it used to be, but it's still big. The mainland is a continent northwest of here, but the colonies used to include Raed Saris and the Deerwood. About 150 years ago, Deerwood won its independence from the Empire, a fact our companions are quick to remind me of. Because it seemed friendlier than Raed Saris? My brothers took over the family mercantile business a few years ago, and there wasn't enough for me to do back home. I moved out to try and expand.
I'll have your water soon enough. Stream's not going anywhere.
Let's check by those outcroppings. This is it.
Thank you.
What a surprise. Sparful went hunting. At least he left the water... Sparful, are you all right? Ambush! Come on, we have to get back to camp.
Get inside! Run!
Was that...
a Buick? Had...
Then we're lucky to be alive.
And we're the only ones.
We can't stay here. There could be another collapse. We're not getting out that way, anyway. Let's get further inside.
That should be far enough. But what now?
We look for another way out. Storm has to die sometime. Someone else has been here. We should move.
See if they left anything useful behind.
Where'd that slime come from? Thank you. Wait. Do you hear that?
I could scout ahead, see what's around the corner.
Fresh air.
Do you feel that?
I think
there's a draft coming through that wall.
Sounds like the storm passed.
I don't hear any sign of that storm either.
Thank you. Oathbinder, bear witness, and see this man has kept his word true to his last breath, full to his blood's last drop. Guide his soul, queen that was, and regard it among your favored. Let his life by the key be his confession. Let his death by the key be his absolution. May he walk the world ever free of the crushing weight.
Thank you. It's high time for some rest.
Hail and well met.
You must be one of the new settlers. Welcome to Gilded Vale. You'll be pleased to know that we've had some recent vacancies here. Of course, we'll need to make some inquiries first. The inestimable Lord Radric the Seventh has taken great pains to insulate our town from Widewind's legacy. Have you ever conceived a Hollowborn child? An infant born without a soul, of course. Lord Radric has made it his first priority to eliminate this scourge from our village. I should warn you, stranger. Here in Gilded Vale, we have a special place for dissidents, charlatans, and those who would hide a curse in our midst. His lordship's wife is with child and due any day now. Without his approval, I shan't be able to find you a permanent settlement. It will have to wait until after the birth. We can continue our interview then, after the bell tolls from Radric's hold to signal my lord's new heir. In the meantime, you can find temporary accommodations at the inn just southwest of here. Whatever your problem, it sounds like a matter for an animancer. However, the only animancer in Gilded Vale isn't in any condition to speak. Consider yourself fortunate. After she failed Lord Radric, we saw to it that she wouldn't profit from the misplaced trust of others. A bad cure is often worse than none at all. But if you're set on finding a bottle of troll piss or a dead Audra pebble to rub on your forehead, you're welcome to check her pockets. A little corpse stink is nothing when you're digging for shit. My advice, however, is to be satisfied that you escaped and leave it at that. Keep out of...
Listen!
Two tolls. Let that be the last.
Three. Gods have mercy.
It seems your arrival is ill-timed. Three bells toll only for the death of a Radric. Fear Lord Radric's heir is lost, or else Hollowborn, and so lost all the same. You should tread carefully. Circumstances have changed a great deal.
Were you looking for someone in that tree? I could introduce you.
I meant no offense. Let's put this matter to rest over a round, shall we? My treat.
Hoping to soothe our pride with a few Adira coppers, eh? We don't need your coin.
Go on. Say it again. I'm itching for an excuse.
Why, you're itching for the kindling touch of your sister, you cocksfeather!
I'll cut that barrel-licking tongue out of your head!
This is a misunderstanding. I didn't say whatever it is you think I said. We've nigh quarreled.
That's where you're wrong.
Not quite how I hoped to get to know the neighbors. Thank you for your timely assistance with that awkward situation. Well, I suppose introductions are in order after that little fiasco. Aloth Corvisor, at your service. Well, I'm a wizard by training, and an adventurer by necessity. I was born in the Seathwood, part of the mainland of the Adir Empire. And both of my parents served the nobility, which afforded me an education for which I am grateful. However, there were no open positions in those houses, and so I decided to seek new means in a new land. And how exactly did you come to be here? In Gwythyn Ruins? Well, those can be dangerous places during the best of times, which these are not. And half the locals would arrest you for trespassing, and the rest would kill you outright. I'm curious, what exactly did you find there? And you survived? I've heard such a thing was impossible. But it seems you either have a knack for timing or the favor of the gods. An excellent question. I came looking for fresh air and cheap land. Instead, the magistrate gave me directions to the inn and a story about the local lord's expectant wife. But I take it that's a familiar tale. Indeed. In that case, welcome to Gilded Vale, a true refuge from civilization. I'm afraid that was a matter of misunderstandings and mistranslations. It doesn't help that people in these parts remember their war with Adir like it was yesterday. Begging your pardon, but neither do you. Yet, circumstances can find a person in the strangest of places. As should I, given recent events. It's just as well. I've had enough of the watered wine and lumpy beds at the inn. They say even the owner tired of the place. Just up and left one day. It explains quite a lot about the upkeep. Perhaps I could join you. I could use a change of scenery, and I find it's better to travel in numbers. Excellent. I shall follow you.
Gods keep you. Greetings. Hello.